Hello, it's Gamescom fan here, back for another day of action. Yesterday we had the Project Wingman, the new trailer and everything, but today we're gonna have this Combat 7 trailer, which some of us may or may not have watched already, including myself. And joining me, we have Active Ace, Sly Cooper fan, Saltus Eversol, and we also have the Rosgrease 108, but you're going to see his profile picture of Garuda. I know it's complicated, okay, but we'll get there. Guys, introduce yourselves.
We'll go in order, I guess, but Active Ace is muted for some reason.
He can't hear us either.
He's shy.
Yeah, no, he can't hear us.
What?
Radio failure.
ECCM. Restore communications.
If he's not here, then Rosgrease is going to have to go first, then me, then Solitus, alphabetically.
Alright, I am Rosgrease 108, aka Talisman. I am the token Amerian. So
thank you.
That's why I have the Garuda emblem.
And what do you do?
Well, I'm a Twitch streamer, and I also most recently contributed to the Ace Combat community by creating a full playlist of video Ace guides for Ace Combat 6. So they'll show you how to spawn and kill all the aces.
There you go. Now you sell yourself.
I'm still new at this.
Meanwhile, I was going to put on the background. That's the stream from IGN. We're waiting for Ace Combat to show up. Should be in 12 minutes from now. You see the countdown right there. And Ace Combat should be the first game.
I hope you guys are enjoying this Hello Neighbor gameplay.
It's very different.
Most of you know me, Sly Cooper Fan 1. I'm on Twitch. I'm on the wiki. I consider myself Ace Combat fan of friends, so enjoying to be here. My voice is dead from last night, so
he had too much fun. He had too much fun.
Project Wingman was a lot of fun, and having Fan on was a lot of fun. So I'm gonna try to calm it down this time, but. Anyway, Solitus, you go.
Hey, everybody. Solitus Eversol here. I am the man behind Strange Real History lore videos. I love talking about Ace Combat lore and making sure, you know, everybody understands the lore, how it's connected from game to game. It's an honor to be here again with everyone. I'm very excited to see number 7 and talk about it with you guys, and I have not seen the trailer, so I'm gonna be reacting probably quite a bit, but I'm gonna try to keep it down.
That's okay. So still gonna have that magic.
We're not gonna try and spoil it for you.
Yeah, guys. I mean, I personally have seen the trailer. I know what's gonna happen, but I'll try to keep it neutral to those who haven't.
I don't know. We'll hold it neutral for that for now.
Yeah, I've got a lot of practice with that with my Mass Effect playthroughs.
Active Ace, you bailed on us. What the hell, man?
I'm sorry, man. I had to do a little bit of some setting up for a little bit of my video. I'm sorry.
He had too much fun.
AKA, he had to take a last-minute trip to the little pilot's room.
I had to ration out the last of my food since, you know, like, I'm stuck in this Belkin cave. I can't really do anything.
Guys, send happy belated birthdays to Active Ace. It was his birthday yesterday.
Yes.
21.
Thank you.
Oh, God, I remember back when I was 21. That was like 10 years ago.
Someone in the chat says, is this human plane?
Listen, I want to talk about this game so much, but no one here is going to be interested in it. But I did play this game's demo, and I'm so interested in it. It has nothing to do with Ace Combat, but there's my little gushing about Haven. I am really looking forward to it. Anyway, Active Ace, we introduced ourselves. Introduce yourself. Let's use Ace Combat Fans' platform for our own game.
Hi, everybody. My name is Active Ace. I have the best... No, I'm just kidding.
Dual time is limited.
I cover news, and also I make cool discussion videos about the game, and I also have a bunch of live stream playthroughs I do of all the Ace Combat games. Check out my channel. It's a lot of fun. If you like Ace Combat, you'll probably like my channel.
And if you don't like Ace Combat, like, I don't know. Like, what are you doing here?
You're productive with your life.
It's okay. I'll show you the path. I'll show you the path, the true path.
Dawn Shade, Ace Combat reveal in about like 10-15 minutes.
8 minutes and 35
minutes. Oh, that's Gamescom starting.
Yes. Then a few more minutes. We're it's going to be the there. First. So we have the trailer and also an interview. And I think it's with Kono, because he tweeted in something in German.
Listen, hopefully, because IGN is not being clear. They're inconsistent whether there's any kind of interview or trailer or, like, gameplay. Like, they have two different things on their video and on their website. So whatever happens, happens at this point.
But they did say interview in both, right?
No, it says... trailer and new gameplay reveal on the video description, but on their website it says gameplay trailer reveal.
But it also has super
interview. So IGN is continuing to screw with us.
So as is, are we
and
seeing
after
gameplay or
all the trouble that you know?
Maybe that's revenge for Kono.
Ends up being the If he ends up being the interviewee, it's going to be some crazy, like,
horror. Yeah.
So I can just see it now. Kono gives the IGN
producers
a copy of Ace. It's like, here, try it with the actual controls instead of...
just a reminder.
Actually give me a rating on this.
Play it again.
To the people who don't remember, like... IGN US, they gave Ace Combat 7 like a 7 score on their review, but then IGN Japan 7 out of 10, and then IGN Japan was like a 9 something.
They got like a 9.5
it was almost 10.
Like, it was insane. Like,
and then Kono just compared them on Twitter side by side, like, come on guys.
Well, it's even better in hindsight. I just rewatched the trailer just for shits and giggles, and at the end it said that the reviewers...
Do you want to spoil? Do you want to spoil?
No, what trailer?
The IGN review.
Oh, okay. I thought you meant the trailer.
Yeah, that one. No, not the trailer. It's set to private. I can't watch it anyway.
I have it downloaded. But it's okay. We don't need it. We'll watch it soon.
Anyway, the reviewer was like, there's a place for, you know, Ace Fighter Jet games to make a comeback, but Ace Combat 7 probably won't be the game to do it. Cut to now where for the 25th anniversary it's like over 2 million units sold.
The third best selling Ace Combat game of all time.
And it's still growing.
It's
probably going to hit number 1 here
I don't think it's going to hit number 1.
You don't think so?
If it took 2 years to get to 2 million, they would have said like 2.3 or 2.5. Like they would have.
Well, but then the thing is, they don't mention. Like it could be almost 2 or 2.1. Took us here.
Hi, welcome.
Hello.
No, we're live.
We're already live. You're just in time.
Yeah. Whoopsie. Sorry about that.
Now I gotta change my
whole
setup.
Setup.
Man. Thanks, Tuga.
Thanks to us.
Thanks for joining late. Not being a damn thing before that.
I'm just happy to be here.
Tuga, real quick, because we introduced ourselves. What do you do?
Who are you?
I had 24 hours to think about this, and I still don't have a good answer. Yo, I do the YouTubes.
No. Go back.
Okay, let's ban him.
No,
that's terrible. No, well, my kind colleagues here focus a bit more on the lore side of Ace Combat things. I'm more of a gameplay freak, and I don't think that'll change anytime soon. So if you're into that, I'm your guy.
Someone was asking earlier about high score runs in Fleet Destruction, and I just linked your video, because I got nothing better.
How do you do that?
Here's the thing, though. That video has the most views of anything I've done at this point. which I'm real proud of. But I've discovered someone pulled up 110. So there's that.
Gotta beat them, Tuga. Come on.
I'm no longer the gamer king anymore. I hate to say
Don't ask me why I farmed forever for the SU-57, and I just linked Tuga's PLSL high score thing. It's like, that's why.
I just want to say thank you for everybody that's coming. We got almost like 800 people. That's crazy.
Jesus.
Yeah. Hey, crap. Thank y'all for showing up, everybody.
Crazy moments.
Now I'm getting stage fright.
Hey, Mr. Anime Military.
It's all right. Don't think about it. Do what I do and don't think about it.
Thank you all for the belated birthday wishes. I appreciate it. I had a lot of fun.
I hope you did.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he had booze, so how could he not
have
fun?
Exactly.
Just drink responsibly, kids. Just, I gotta put it out.
Exactly.
Family-friendly content.
Just
no, we have to. I only condone drinking if you're 21, guys.
Please.
Drink your water, people.
When you get my age, drinking's kind of like, whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, no,
Americans.
I don't even bother. I can't stand it. I don't know how anyone stands it.
I don't drink
Sukhoi,
either.
I
don't
see
know,
you in
man.
The chat.
It's been a long while since
I've
been.
I hate the taste of beer. It's... Ugh.
Just really quick, bring the sales thing up. Just really quick, Ace Combat 7 sales are going to slow down, really after release. So by now, if it hasn't surpassed Air Combat, it's not going to surpass Ace Combat 4. It might surpass Air Combat. We don't know. There's a couple years out. We're getting new DLC. Who knows? But I don't think it's going to hit 2. Ace Combat 4 is 2.6 million.
But then the thing is, we don't know the complete number. We know it's above
right.
2, but we don't.
You're right.
Like, it could be 2.3. It could be. I don't know.
You're absolutely right. It could be. They probably just would have rounded it to, the 5. The 500,000. So,
yeah.
We don't know. But
I'm just glad that 7 had the chance to do this well.
It is still, there is no squandering its accomplishment. Third best Ace Combat game sold 2 million copies. That's nothing to say, oh, that's nothing. No, that's big.
And I would say it came out...
I think it's past its
peak. The Air Combat and Ace Combat 4 had more, how should I say, better release windows. One was a launch title for PS1. The code for the US version is literally US-US-00001.
You're right. You're right.
We are number one.
Imagine if Ace Combat 8 ended up as a PS5 launch title. It's not happening. It's not happening.
Yeah, but can you imagine?
It's false hype.
It would be interesting if we had that moment again.
Oh, yeah. I would, my body would not be ready, to say the least.
Everyone in chat is like, what are we watching? Guys, Gamescom is not just Ace Combat.
Unfortunately.
We got a few seconds.
It's not just planes, you know.
Be respectful to the other games. You gotta
There's
be
nice. Life behind the planes.
I really am looking forward to this.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm looking at this and I'm thinking, this looks like No Man's Sky without the planes.
Wait, so this... nah, this looks like Gravity Falls. Gravity Rush, I'm sorry.
No. I know what you meant. Gravity Rush. The graphics are...
Gravity
I didn't
Rush.
Even think about that.
Yeah,
no,
dude.
Gravity Falls.
Gravity Falls. Wait, two different things we're talking about
I'd be surprised if Gravity Falls got a video game. But then again, South Park got a video game, so nothing matters anymore.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
Anything can be a video game.
I just want to pilot with Mabel's voice actor.
Okay.
Could I put the sound now for the stream?
Oh, no. Rest in peace.
Will remain a
rest in
beacon
peace.
Of integrity,
yeah, Black Panther.
And hope.
That Wakanda
Chris
forever.
And his powerful
Wakanda forever,
like Bloods, Wakanda forever. Marshall N42, he'll be forever.
Oh, we got a super chat from Nicola Ocello.
In lieu of a moment of silence,
burn this room in your memory, guys.
Scene from his presence.
I see it's an OC in writing.
As the Avengers face
we'll... see how these fellow YouTube Twitch ages together. Nevermore.
We now know that it's
Nevermore. Evermore. Thank you, guys. That's a bit.
Behind the scenes.
That's some Edgar Allan Poe going on.
Incredible testament to the human spirit.
Oh my god, it's McKinsey.
For
no!
Rest in power.
Rest in power. Thanks for the super chat, though.
Hit with that copyright.
Oh no, no! You gotta turn it down, ACF.
Yeah,
you can't.
Let's pause this. Let's pause this. Nothing is happening.
I really like Civil War.
Everyone that's streaming this right now, they just got shut down. YouTube, Twitch, this was all done to shut them down.
Let's pause and look at this moment. Come on, come on. I know.
I would love to give a moment of silence, but we can't. This is copyrighted material. We can't.
Okay, actually, now that this is getting brought up, though, I just saw the clip where Black Panther appears in Endgame, and the fucking theater is like going wild over that scene. And it's it's bone chilling. It's so awesome.
When the scene is done, just let me know, guys. Okay.
It's done.
I'm watching.
It's done. It's done. Okay, we go back to live.
Yeah.
Rest in peace, Chadwick Boseman. I saw people in the chat asking. No, he passed away, 43, to cancer.
Yeah.
While I was on Discord with you last on Pokemon, that's when I found out. I just didn't want to carry it over to the stream to bring it down.
I didn't want to carry it over either, but
Before this, I was the reason I was late and completely forgot about it. I was watching Formula 1, and I learned of this because Lewis Hamilton dedicated this poll to him, and I was like, what? So that was one way of learning about it.
1,000 people are watching us.
What?
Oh, God.
Oh my
God. You guys are crazy! Wow. But that's good.
That's
good.
Crazy
for
combat. So many people. Thank you guys for coming out. We really appreciate you.
Yes.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. It's been a while for me. I made like, what, 5 videos this year? Hey!
Let's go.
There. It was seen very seen, but oh my God, I got
to convex. Man, that takes me back.
That is like one of the first trailers.
Gatolinas are just pawns. Plus,
IGN, what are you doing? Ready, because
Gamescom Studio, they couldn't find anything. They had to go that far back. Right now.
IGN, you continue to disappoint me.
They couldn't get through the entire game without, you know, outsourcing their gameplay.
You're right. 7 out of 10, too much sky.
Hello, Italy.
Guys.
Oh,
here we go.
Is it time?
Yes.
It's time.
It's Bandai Namco. There's the 25th anniversary logo.
12.
Oh, the logo.
Oh, we're starting with it.
And there it goes.
There it is.
There's a trailer we saw.
Salutus.
That's my baby!
Gentlemen, I do not believe a lady on Earth will be able to resist us.
It's the run dirty wild. Bat itself. No,
my baby. That's
my
right
baby.
There it is. The
I don't care. I don't care if she's getting nerfed. That's my baby.
That's my boy. It's been a while.
Here's a surprise. All the Zero skins. All of them.
Cypher for
them except Sorcerer. Except Sorcerer.
Well, there's
all of them.
15 out of 15.
Name Lord of the Round Table, I pray for your success.
Oh.
Wow,
but wait, there's more.
Wait, did you see that end part?
Yeah.
No, that was just multiplayer.
Casual easy level now for IGN journalists.
Commemoration update is available now.
Wait, what?
We gotta get the skins.
Welcome to Gamescom Studio Day 3. I am Max Scoville, and we just got to look at an exclusive trailer for the new DLC coming to Ace Combat 7, Skies Unknown. It looks like a whole lot of jets. We'll have more on that later on. I'm joined right now by my esteemed colleagues, Brian Altano and Miranda Sanchez.
I guess they're doing the intro. Let's see if we're going to have the interview.
Well, aside from the jets, we've got a block of exclusive trailer reveals, followed by demos.
Okay, they're talking about the rest of the lineup.
Including King's Bounty 2, and later on,
guys, the update that's available now is the free updates we've had this year. It's not the DLC.
We worked really hard.
Yeah.
Awesome and the indie, and we came up with this Gamescom. Like, awesome.
So that is in fact the exact same trailer, just localized.
In English. Global to see all the newest games content. The release date for the East Plane should be sometime this fall.
Available for purchase autumn 2020. Confirmed, by the way, it is purchase, not free.
Yes. Which
I don't know why people thought for some reason to be free.
I'm assuming
are they
gonna
be all in one pack, or
we don't know. Nothing was said. The other thing is a new difficulty level, casual easy, will be added to
IGN difficulty.
IGN difficulty.
You're young, inexperienced.
Will be added actually for free to the campaign mode for players to enjoy. Adventure.
Okay. Players won't enjoy. Like only the noobs will enjoy.
Have the easy difficulty in 7 have crash mitigation?
Well, my curiosity is like if they're going to.
Will you be able to establish?
A oh, thanks for the super chats, by the way.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Sorry, I couldn't read it. It was always in the trailer. Like, world trailer. Danger.
You are surviving. Why are they adding that difficulty 2 years later? Are you, ready to
face the harsh? Right.
Yeah.
There's a reason for it. There's a reason it exists, and we'll have to wait until we see it in action to see what's up.
Sly it so you can S rank a whole new difficulty.
Wait, guys. I need to answer this because everyone, for some reason, keeps thinking. No, the season pass, the deluxe edition, the Strangeville edition, the special edition, you are not getting those DLC aircraft for free. Nosferatu, SFA 27, Shinden 2, you have to pay for them.
And they're probably not going with the season pass that we had, by the way.
No, they're not going. Yeah, they're not going into that season pass.
Separate purchase. Because I know a lot of people are asking that, if it's going to be a part of it. No, it's a completely new...
I've seen some people ask if there's going to be a new season pass, like season 2.
If there is you going know to be what, a new though, season pass, we don't know.
With them adding a new difficulty, I think it would make sense they would put more levels, like 3 DLC missions or something. If they're putting a new easy difficulty. I kind of see them related, but I don't have any evidence.
I could see that. I mean, we did see a little snippet at the very end of that clip, and it was a red beam.
I know why there's a new casual difficulty. It's so IGN can actually review the DLC missions.
And then maybe we'll go up 1 point on the review scale.
If they found Charge Assault hard, how are they going to get through Unexpected Visitor?
Wait. Are you just being, was that an actual thing, or are you just joking?
Oh my god, is this...
That might be a slight exaggeration, but
it's an exaggeration, but...
I would not be surprised.
They did have a hard time with some of the later missions because they didn't pay attention to the briefings and skipped everything.
Guys, unrelated, this is the new Fortnite update. Isn't that insane?
What?
That's Fortnite.
This isn't Fortnite. This is a new game called Scourgebringer.
Okay, well, it's even better than Fortnite.
No, I'm sorry. It's not Sea of Thieves.
I mean, I could believe it, honestly.
It's Fortnite with boats.
I mean, that's not.
I never played Fortnite. I don't intend to.
I have some genuine
admiration for the development cycle.
Although watching Sly, keep getting his ship sunk on stream is hilarious.
Listen.
In large part because he can't steer and just heads into the rocks.
Blazing Sea. So it is a battle royale of some sort.
Everything's a battle royale these days.
Oh no, Scourgebringer was the last one. Never mind. Well, here's the thing now. We're getting all these trailer reveals and...
Both night.
Well, they said they're going to talk more about Ace Combat, right?
I hope so.
That's what they said.
They're just going to show trailers first and then talk about...
That is the thing. Like, we're already, almost done with the list, so there's probably more coming.
Right. Yeah. We haven't even had the producer interview yet, either. So I'm assuming they're saving that till later.
If I don't see an interview, I'm going to Twitter.
There's nothing on Twitter, I can tell you that right now.
Wait, actually, that's a lie. There's Kono, and he tweeted in German, and,
Well, that was yesterday. I'm saying now.
Oh. Yeah, they're not gonna live tweet.
Now, will the producer interview be in English, German, or Japanese? Because I can speak one of those.
I don't know. Kono, they probably would have something pre-recorded. Maybe put subtitles on what Kono's saying.
Absolutely. There's no way that they're doing it live.
No. Yeah, pre-recorded.
Yeah. you know they're gonna have a translator and some guy talking in English over whatever they're saying too. It's like, I don't know. I feel like that's what they do.
What game is this? Like Overcooked or something?
Potion Party.
This winter, only on PS4.
But it does look like Cooking Mama, but with potions.
Yeah.
All right. Just now, look at four new video game trailers: Medieval Dynasty, Scourgebringer, Blazing Sails.
Oh, we have a super chat from Rosgaries.
So, what do we think of them? Let's start with Medieval Dynasty.
Not me.
not this right. Not the Rosgaries that has the Garuda emblem on the stream. That's complicated story. Okay. Hey, Alex. I've almost finished designing the new difficulty, but I've got a question for you, Alex.
You know,
can we really do this to get good IGN review? It's a tough mission.
Hey Alex, I've almost finished designing the new difficulty.
I wouldn't want to be in
perfect
feudal times, but
I've got a question for you, Alex.
That's an experience.
Can we really do this to get a good IGN review?
I like what they're doing, just sort of like the simplicity of it all. But it's also, you know, obviously games have allowed you to sort of like build out your homestead and, you know, keep it safe against.
That's what I'm thinking, Unsighted Raptor.
Such, but
it sounds like the very easy difficulty from the previous game. Really so, but there has to be a reason they're adding it 2 years later.
Yeah.
Besides IGN.
I can't remember. What was the difference between the very easy and easy in previous games?
Just
that.
Pretty much.
I think you bounce better, too.
Because easy already has damage mitigation on ground.
Well, I've seen theories that they might take a page from A6's easy difficulty, where they just give you more weapons. Because the easy difficulty of A6, you get double the weapons.
That would be annoying, because I'd want that. I'd want that, but not. I wouldn't want to play on very easy to get it.
You don't want to play on super hard and try to get the hard, yeah.
Right.
ACF, by the way, if you want to just like loop that part of the stream, I'll tell you when something new comes up.
Sounds good.
Because everyone's looking at some random gameplay right now.
Yeah. Let's go back to AC.
I don't know what this is.
It's,
also just,
it's ball it's shooter. Like, sort of
minus 8 minutes. Minus 9 minutes.
Aesthetic, but it's clearly going really
there.
Just
okay,
fast.
There you go.
Careful.
There you go. There you go.
My thing is that red beam of light. That had to be new gameplay, right? Like I'm not.
No, it's not. It's
that's
that
just multiplayer.
Morgan.
It's
yeah,
the
that
pixie
was
Morgan firing his TLS in multiplayer.
Against Cypher.
Why did you? What made you think?
I don't know. Okay, it could have been.
He drank too much.
It wasn't the hangover.
It's the hangover talking.
We had too much talk about red lasers yesterday. And possibly taking off Ben's head, but that's a different story.
You know what? I was gonna express my thoughts on what I really thought it was, but then you're right. I'm not gonna let my brain talk anymore.
You've done it now. Now we need to hear.
Yeah, you've teased us. Continue.
What'd you think it was?
Oh my god, don't make me say it, please.
Excalibur?
Do it!
Yes! Yeah, the Excalibur.
It's not a bad theory.
I would
still
pay real money for an Excalibur like mission, like DLC mission,
like
Infinity.
Can you blame me? Like
no, I won't blame you.
Okay. I had a little bit of hope.
I can't believe we're getting all the zero
stories coming to the consoles. That was like one of the one things I was wanting for, ever since they released the Pixie skins. Like, you give us Pixie, but no Cypher. Why?
It's two different things, because PC modders are going to be like, oh, we've had these skins. Like, well, no, you get more skin slots now.
Exactly.
Yes.
You get the legit one. You get the actual skin, not your made-up skin.
Well, console peasants are like, yes, more things.
Finally! The wage is over.
Some mods are kind of almost a bit better than some.
The one. One skin that I kind of felt like I kind of expected them to have in there, especially with the Nosferatu, would have been the SC-33 Striggan.
Here's
but
the thing.
I'm
we
not complaining,
no, though. We do not have the full details. Because
we
had the 25th anniversary wallpaper, and We saw a lot of skins in there that aren't in this trailer.
Also, I mean, the skin is there.
Can I say
somebody in the chat just said friendship ended with F15J Ronin?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. All of us console players are like, yeah, friendship ended.
Actually, were you going to say something?
Players already friendship ended with F15J in general. You guys realize that, like,
for the 25th anniversary, if obviously all the plans didn't get destroyed, that we would have probably had all of this in one drop. Possibly 1 week span of
no,
like a...
we would have had this sooner.
Well, that's probably what I mean, though.
Like, no, not like, but we wouldn't have had it like all together. It would have been in the
that
summer.
That would be overload.
Yeah.
Well, you don't think they would have dropped it around the 25th anniversary?
I think.
Well, I guess that was their goal, but
anniversary.
But
I don't think.
Happen.
I think the Nosferatu would have dropped.
Yeah, the Nosferatu would have dropped.
Okay, I see where you guys are going.
But the XFA-27 would probably be late summer, and then the Shinden would be toward mid-fall.
Yeah.
Yeah,
they would have done the same
even
thing
on
the first DLC pack.
Yeah, if on a normal release schedule they spread aircraft apart, there's no reason why they wouldn't do it.
But I also meant in light of like the skins dropping, the US skins, and obviously the Rage skin as well. I forget what it's called, the commemoration update, and then
the Mimic skins, the Alicorn skin, the emblems that they added. Yeah.
Yeah, that stuff would have released as well as the US skin series on the 25th anniversary.
Oh,
sure.
Probably.
And then they would have dropped the trailer, which would have led to them, like Sly said, you know, dropping throughout the summer.
Kono asked for, like, he basically asked for forgiveness because they had a lot planned. They were planning this year for a global Ace Combat Symphony, like the in-person orchestra. No, he sent this on Twitter.
And then 2020 was just like, yeah, no.
Yeah, they couldn't do it anymore.
I would have traveled for that, honestly.
The anniversary had to be put on hold. So I don't want to hear anyone being so entitled, like, oh, this would be for free or something, you know?
But don't worry, we're here to dispel those misconceptions, you know?
Yeah.
We're here to put, you know, and people who overtake, you know, overreact to things, you know, like, oh, it should be free, or, oh, this is bad, or, oh, this is terrible. We're here to put them in their place, so we're not here to do that.
Yeah. Let's put it this way. I'm broke. I will be buying the Nosferatu DLC day one.
Oh god, I know you are.
Oh god, yes.
Yeah,
priorities. It's funny, guys. No, this is Rosgrease. He uses the Garuda emblem, but he likes the Nosferatu better.
Kono just tweeted.
Ace-6 was my first Ace Combat game.
Kono just tweeted. That Ace Combat trailer, did you finish watching? Well, thank you very much for your patience. The world is tough right now. Our development was also affected. I'm glad we managed to make this announcement safely. The three aircraft we selected are the result of our research daily on Twitter.
What?
Holy crap! They literally gave the people what they wanted.
Kono cares. Wow. Hashtag Kono cares.
Hashtag
Kono cares.
Please understand. Please understand.
Everybody put it in. Hashtag Kono cares.
I think, Ace Combat fan, you might have to clear this one up for me. I think he's saying that they had 44 developers? Or am I misreading that?
Well, let's see if my Japanese is that good.
Yeah, the translation is not great, but...
Oh, Japanese translation is always messed up.
No, no. Listen, you want to... Really it would not be family friendly if I explained to you what Microsoft always
thinks. No, but I think that's the meaning.
Hey, were we not supposed to curse on the stream?
Well,
hang on.
Who the fuck cares?
We've been going on this part now.
Kono cares. Kono cares.
Azure Sky, I'll take a look at it.
Yeah. 44 people.
I'm gonna take requests.
So it is 44 people, okay.
44 people, a development team.
Because he awesome. Implied, like, at first this was impossible.
Yeah.
So they have 44 people working and they weren't even sure if they could manage to get this done. That's how bad of a situation it is for them.
Yeah.
Well, if they have the trailer released, I think they're pretty confident that they can get it done.
Oh, no, no. His meaning is that they did get it done, but they weren't...
They didn't know in the beginning. Dang.
Okay, it seems like they've been, like, up until the last minute with this kind of stuff.
You know what's weird?
Oh, it's Comet.
Is Comet alive?
Live! Live! Go live!
Live, 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 live! We're live, we're live, we're live.
We're live. Peggy 12.
Oh?
Again? Same trailer again?
Again?
I hope not.
It better not be the same trailer.
Come on,
it
looks guys. Like the
Come
same.
Come on, IGN.
Oh, for fuck's
wait,
sake.
Wait, wait for it. Wait for it.
Oh, no way.
Wait, is this... Oh, there he is!
It's fucking Kono.
Jeez,
it looks tired, man.
Grizzled.
That hair.
That is quarantine in effect right there.
Jeez. I feel bad for him. He looks so tired.
I thought it hit me bad.
No, thank you, sir. Sir, thank
you. No, thank you.
Yeah.
New downloadable content.
Yeah. Hold on.
Wait, what?
Content.
Talk about the aircraft. Yeah, people expected this.
If I see gameplay, rapid fire EML. Right.
Oh, here you go, ACF. It's your boy.
My boy.
I'm glad we actually get this introspective into these.
Yeah, me too.
I do like the Shinden.
I can't wait to fly this plane.
Right.
Like, it's so cute.
It's also pretty damn bird.
Macross reference now.
It's versatile as hell.
So, is the Golden Nugget skin confirmed?
No.
Not yet.
That's probably going to be a mod.
That's classified.
About the transformation.
Oh yeah, how it changes in flight.
Wait, does that mean
Dude, I could listen to this man talk about planes.
That jacket is so clean.
Look at his watch, too.
I know.
STOV, whoa, cool.
That's so cool.
Oh, we don't have that.
No, that's not playable, no.
No, the VTOL, no. You kind of get a feel for it, I think, in Assault Horizon if you go too slow.
Yeah.
It's almost like it's becoming, but it's...
If you high G turn.
No, not the high G turn. If you stall speed, like, it almost VTOLs.
You can VTOL with anything in Assault Horizon.
No, but it was like this.
It actually changes the shape.
No, that's what I'm saying. If you DFM an airplane that's VTOLing, you'll VTOL too. Because it'll just hover at whatever speed he's doing.
They based this technically off the F-35 before they even knew they were going to get the F-35.
Yeah.
That is so cool.
Wow.
Oh, they weren't even looking at the F-35 back then. They wanted the F-22.
We're not getting VTOL gameplay, guys. Relax there.
Yeah.
They're talking about the actual, like, layout and design of the aircraft.
The lore material.
Yeah.
So skin predictions for this.
Task Force 8. Yeah, Nagase.
Definitely.
Yeah, the Edge.
I'm pretty sure
Ridgebacks would be good.
Please, I would love to see the Ridgebacks.
My money on it.
You know,
I really want it.
I think Kono was hinting that he was going to be the one for the interview because he posted a picture on Instagram with that same background.
Like, yeah.
He did, yeah.
Yeah.
So I guess it makes sense.
Unfortunately, they're not getting the F-22 because according to Congress, it is illegal for us or the United States to export the F-22.
Yeah.
We need to clip this.
I really look forward to this video being fully available because
same.
ACF, you're gonna pick this apart, the Shinden part.
Yes.
Thank you,
my good sir. Oh my god.
I wonder if he's gonna bring up like its balance.
Fight with a vast number of enemy aircraft. Yes, sir. The ADMMs.
ADMMs.
And that's why we love.
I know they're gonna get nerfed. I just.
Well, let's see. Let's see if he brings it up.
Despite its smart looks, it
and
is...
the EML rail.
EML.
Yeah. Rapid fire.
Confirmed.
We just need to know the fire rate.
It was rapid fire.
Pinhead, your time is up.
What does he mean by smart appearance?
It looks like a natural.
It looks sleek.
Okay, that I did not know.
Oh, that's cool.
I did not know that either.
I had
like 44 Magnum? What?
Finally.
Carrier fighter
who
attacker.
Would have expected?
Finally.
Who would have expected?
44 Magnum.
We're learning lore!
I forgot I did dual lore. Magnum. Do you not love your rift?
This is a gunslinger. This is a gunslinger.
Okay, next time I do that,
my meme is correct.
I am so happy we finally got that.
Wow. Blasted.
We get to know the reason behind that. That is beautiful.
Guys, I literally call this thing the flying dagger. That's what it looks like.
And that's
upper side Kono,
like
on the bottom side too.
Oh, show me that bottom.
I swear, if they show gameplay of a rapid fire EML, I'm gonna flip.
Oh, dude, the cockpit view is gonna be so cool.
Dude, just looking at the planes like this, so beautiful.
Oh, there's gonna be, because think about it, there will be reflection in the cockpit when you see the pods.
Yes.
Oh.
That's what I'm excited about.
Because Seven's cockpits are freaking incredible.
Yep.
Weapons attacks fitted on the wings. Especially, he omitted there on top of the wings.
Weapons and so on from third person in the cockpit views.
How about some
I can't
mission
wait
content?
To see
no.
Switching from, you know.
Fine, we need
to update the wings. To my special weapons and the ADMMs pop out. Oh. It's going to be such
so
a.
So yeah, the IGN chat's going.
Yeah.
Oh, they don't care.
I can understand them. This is a bit too much in depth for anyone.
This is not for Gamescom.
This is for Ace Combat.
That makes sense now. Now I understand why it's like a pancake.
Holy
shit. They made it too big.
Way too big.
The baby is too big.
Too thick. To the hangers.
We had to shrink. We actually had to apply some G-force
for the thickness
to the thing and shrink it down. Why is there no Nosferatu?
I know.
My baby's too thick.
It'll be available this time, so you know, please understand.
My baby. Here we go, boys. Here we go.
Oh, yeah.
To say the least, many people
the
were.
The OG.
One of the
what its weapons are going to be.
Oh, yeah.
I really freaking hope they do the four standard missiles instead of MSTM.
I really do as well. I really do. There's no way they wouldn't, right? I mean,
no, they gave us MSTM.
This is my point.
Oh, you're right. That's true.
Well, that was a part.
No, not in Infinity.
That was in X.
Yeah, X had the part.
Wow.
I never got the XFA in
ADF-01.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, two of them arrival. They were the first fictionals.
Yeah. Oh, here we go on the lore.
I did not know that, but it makes sense because it's a carrier aircraft.
Yep.
That makes very much sense.
Especially the F-14. I didn't know that, but I can kind of see it now.
No, we had no idea, but that makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God. Now I see the inspiration for all three.
That's
the
so F-17, cool.
117, the 22, and the 23.
I always wonder
and the 14.
How they thought of making these planes. Like, who just wakes up in the morning and is like, ah, this
oh, that's where the X2 came.
They're gonna make it forward swept?
That's where the X2 came from later on, I guess.
Oh,
wow.
Too implausible. Oh, that's too much.
too much.
Actually, I think that
yeah, there you go. Oh.
Yeah, exactly.
We'll
there you go.
To the XO 2A and a later year.
Like,
wow.
Like, oh, it was too much back then.
Yeah.
What?
Well, maybe it was too much for
Transformers.
The PS1.
Well, originally designed. It's not that they are.
Thrust reverser and for Yahaver, and it's coming up the time to process.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, because it was all so blocky.
Maybe they'll put that in now.
If they made an S version of this plane, you know what they would add into it to upgrade
someone,
it.
Someone said, I want Breath of the Wild 2. Like, okay.
Those are SOD.
Oh, okay, shut up.
Yeah,
this isn't E3, dude.
Those are SODs on the, under there.
Yep, we already confirmed that.
Uh-huh. SOD.
Wait, I mean when the trailer was leaked.
You think they might have the ODMM?
I'm worried that it's either going to be the ODMM or the MSCM.
I actually like the ODMM.
That will be a cop out from the.
I'm so glad they noticed that because I noticed that with the Falcon too.
Uh-huh.
We added a folding mechanism in a
hurry. So these planes weren't added in because they were trying to figure out how to make them work. And animate.
Yeah. Nosferatu, too thick.
Only the Nosferatu, because the XFA-27 was solved in Infinity.
Was triple C's a little too thick.
Oh, did it froze?
Don't be jealous of my baby.
Is it only...
Okay.
It froze.
Oh, okay.
Reintroduce Atlas.
Yeah. IGN's had that problem.
This time, Shinden.
And?
Two.
And?
What do you mean, and?
Holy, that's 7 skins for each of the 3.
Golden Nugget!
Golden Nugget, let's go!
Blue,
well, 3 of those are going to be the...
27, please.
There you go.
Cypher skin for which we...
10 more aircraft skins for 0 will be included, so 30 skins in this DLC. That is
that's crazy.
That's 21 skins for the 3 new aircraft.
And emblems.
Yes!
Emblems! We're getting emblems!
More emblems, yes!
I guess it's gonna be the 0 emblem.
No, the 0 was already there.
20 types of emblems.
Give me the Butterfly Master.
This man is the GOAT. No, thank you, Kono. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Will they,
thanks, Kono.
Will they give everyone Kono. The, paid exclusive?
We understand.
We understand, yeah.
Oh, no.
Autumn 2020.
We totally understand,
well,
Kono.
There it is.
That's it.
There it was.
That was good.
That
okay.
was Ace Combat 7, a game that will allow you to lift off into the sky, which
it
is wonderful in a year where
the
you
sky.
Can't leave your apartment. We have to take a quick break.
Oh,
and we'll
have
more Gamescom right after this.
Hire us. We'll help you with flight games.
Don't trust IGN.
Yeah, they can't be trusted.
I'm just going to put that interview with Kono again
in
playback.
Oh my god, dude. The chat is so toxic. They're like, oh wow, that was pointless.
It's hurting.
That was so
fuck
pointless.
Them. I've already closed the tab.
Yeah.
It's the IGN people.
About? What is this? Who is this guy? Man, go somewhere else.
Yeah, I can't stand the IGN.
Why am I watching a thing that's not exclusively what I want?
Wait,
this
I
is
just closed the tab. It's
just for me, isn't it?
Well, it reminds me of the band. Whenever Bandai Namco tweets out Ace Combat stuff, you get those.
God, the Jump Force fan.
Jump Force! Come on, guy, you need Goku to fight this guy, and then. No.
How long did Jump Force last, everybody? Yeah.
The thing is, Ace Combat 7 was on the schedule. What? But.
It was first up, you knew.
Yeah.
Yeah, but here's the thing, people don't read. So.
I'm kind of disappointed that Kono didn't take another shot at IGN America.
Not when on their fucking live. I'm so disappointed in him. But
maybe he did in Japanese, and the translator didn't put it.
True. Oh, I can't tell.
You just tweeted, no, did you use it completely?
Did you use it completely?
But did Kano say that 7 was made by 44 people, or was he talking about the Nosferatu? He was talking about the current...
I think the development team.
My baby was literally created by 44 developers.
Yeah, oh yeah.
That's why she's so thick.
Second beautiful. That was... Okay. Now, that was awesome to find out that the XFA-27 was originally going to have forward swept designed wings, but they scrapped that idea and later used that idea to create the Wyvern. That is awesome.
I love that they thought it was too much.
We got a lot of, I know. He's like, listen, it's impossible.
We got a lot of behind the scenes looks here because
with
like the development thoughts and inspirations into the Shinden, the problems with porting the Nosferatu into 7 and its original design, and his excitement for people to see it in the cockpit view, like, oh wait, those weapons came up.
And we found out where the number came from, 44.
Yeah. We finally get, and carrier fighter attacker. Everyone thought that was it, but finally we have official confirmation.
So from now on, if you watch my A6 streams and I'm doing the Nosferatu EML, I'm going to call it the Dirty Harry.
Yeah. Dirty
I'm just gonna keep in mind that
it's Dirty Dan.
It was too thick for the hangar.
Yeah.
Here's the thing though.
Does that mean that flying the Nosferatu in third person is going to give us the same wide camera as the Raven?
Oh, I hope so.
Oh yeah, I really do hope so.
Ooh. Hey, but that's the thing. I mean,
the Nosferatu is not really that wide. It's just long.
It's not that wide. No, it's long.
It's not.
Oh,
yes.
Okay. Right.
Yeah, it's how long it is. Isn't it longer than the XFA-27?
He said 25 meters in the interview.
Jeez. Oh, that's a lot.
Yeah.
Well, I was kind of surprised that the Falcon didn't clip out in that, you know, where you're doing the elevator on the carrier. Because that Falcon's nose is long as hell.
I feel like... Oh, we got a super chat from Ribbon. He's here again.
Ribbon Blue.
At least we had the real stream here. Need to get going, but thanks for this stream and putting the facts in the chat. Well, thanks.
Yeah, what I'm anticipating is people who've never played A6 flying the Nosferatu for the first time and wondering why they're crashing while they're doing, you know, low speed strafing runs.
I'm not surprised, but I'm also, you know, not disappointed, but, like, I wish we could have seen some gameplay more than the quick trailer.
You know,
I would love to see, like, how is the physics going to be? How is the Nosferatu's weapons going
to
be?
Yeah, going to handle. Yep. We need to know the fire rate. That's what we need to know of the EML.
Yes, that is well.
Nerfed damage for the Nosferatu's EML if they up the fire rate. Because there's two guns.
Yeah.
So, like, half damage for twice the fire rate, I'd be okay with that.
Or maybe they can keep the same fire rate, but just really put a really low ammo count.
Do you guys think they're going
to... No, we don't think. Don't think. It's better not to think.
Okay. It hurts to think.
Okay. It's going to be up close personal shotguns.
Are they going to upload the trailer again to the official Ace Combat channel, or is it going to be on IGN?
Are you saying
like on IGN? Lengthened.
You want to see the trailer unlocked so that we have all the comments there?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. I don't know.
It will be back.
One alternative they have for the CFA is make it basically a double-barreled shotgun, long reload between the two shots, and then just. But you can fire them both instantly.
Now, they uploaded the interview and stuff.
I feel though, like what they
wonder
probably
how bad
would
they're
do.
Gonna nerf the ADMM, because that got hit hard on the port to Assault Horizon.
Yeah.
It got a little bit like resolved with Infinity's upgrade system, but even then, it was still. I'm curious how it's gonna lock on. And how it's
not,
and then how it's gonna, yeah, because like we have the 8 AAM and the 8 AGM, like people, for some reason, have problems with those. Come on, guys. Because
it double locks.
Just quick fire. It's not that difficult.
One misses on purpose, the other strikes true.
I realize you don't want to think about when you fire, but come on.
Oh, look, we have a super chat.
Another super chat.
Wait, hold on, guys. Jonathan Moore.
Super chat time from Great Jonathan talk. Moore. Oh, you want to read active? Great. Go ahead.
Oh, okay. Great talk from the Mad Lad Kono. I understand the lack of other stuff, but hey, at least we get more V2. I do hope that one day they give us an update on the PC VR. My HOTUS and Vive are waiting.
Never. PC VR, never.
For AC7, no. There are some workarounds. There are some workarounds that you can use a VR headset to play Ace Combat 7, I guess. But that's just with simulating. It's not the same thing as a full support.
So, I guess one quick question, because I'm kind of looking at the chat in Discords. Is this going to be, you know, since it is paid, is it going to be one payment to get all three aircraft?
We don't know that.
Okay.
I'm assuming it's going to be like the last DLC pack that we got, where they're going to be like, they're going to drop a plane, and that's going to be, I don't know, like $5. The next plane is going to be $5 a few months down the road. So the I'm assuming they're going to spread it out.
But. We had the three aircraft before, and they split up the skins and emblems. So if this ends up being like, because how do you split up the Zero skins between three completely unrelated aircraft to Zero? So I don't know.
Well, obviously the Cypher one should go with an Nosferatu.
That doesn't make sense, but okay.
It does, yeah.
But it does, because that's probably the only one I'm going to be able to afford.
Yeah. So, no. Cypher goes to the Shinden. I don't even know if I'm going to get the Nosferatu if I have an option.
I'm going to get all three. I need to play all these.
Yeah.
I would love to get all three. I don't know if I'm really, like, dying to buy the Nosferatu.
I know.
Just because you can't fly it, Sly, doesn't mean you're a bad aircraft.
What are you?
I didn't say it's a bad aircraft. Oof. I said I don't want to fly it.
Are you an XF-327?
According to your streams, you keep crashing because you don't know how to fly it.
Yeah, I didn't say it's a bad aircraft. I said I don't want to fly it.
He said he touched the Nosferatu and he's like 2 out of 10.
This is like waifu wars.
I will buy the Shinden and XFA-27 for sure.
That's good taste.
He doesn't like the Nosferatu.
It's okay, Sly. It's okay. You don't have to lose control. It's fine.
I need my Ridgeback skin. I need my XFA-27. It had like an aggressor camo in Infinity.
It did.
I do need the Happy New Year nugget. Give me that.
The golden nugget. Wait,
look, if they don't give us, I will make one.
The little
we'll make the golden nugget. Picture. There is a solution to our problems.
No. I don't want just the golden nugget. I wanted to say Happy New Year 2015.
Oh, you don't want to update it to say Happy 2020, huh?
No, 2015. Bring me back Infinity.
Hey, you know what?
Metroid, thank you for the Super Chat to Ace Combat fan.
Metroid Epic, yeah, you buy for Sly. No excuses now.
So, Sly, you know me. I wasn't a fan of the Wyvern when I first started playing with the Wyvern in the past. But I've warmed up to it. And I understand where the fun is.
Listen,
I think the same thing with the Nosferatu.
I am so beyond grateful that you really warmed up to the Wyvern as a Nosferatu fan. I really appreciate that. Fuck the Nosferatu. It can go.
As Patrick said, sometimes we have to look deep inside ourselves to solve our problem.
What are you talking about?
It's an enigma of my machinations that my mind.
You gotta solve that issue.
Sly's just salty that
You're just salty.
Another super chat this time from Nosferatu. I hope they will bring that the NTDM.
No, aircraft only.
So
let's get a count here. What is our favorite fictional Ace Combat plane as of now?
Do I really need to say?
Do we need to say that?
Then that's for us.
Like, what are you talking about?
I want to get a list now.
Look, I don't care. I don't care about your arguments, but only the Shin has the nugget inside in the cockpit. Can you beat that? Can you beat that?
Not true.
Not true.
The EA6B.
That's not original, okay? That's not original.
Listen, what's original about it is that it has four nuggets.
I'm muting you, Sly.
It has five nuggets, actually. It has four nuggets and it has a picture of Mrs. Nugget on the cockpit.
Okay, four nuggets and a picture of Sweetie. Fine.
Chat, return again.
I mean, it's actually a rubber nugget.
And don't say Mrs. Nugget. That's his sister.
Guys,
no, I would
let's just, not.
No, that was her name.
Think about this.
Sweetie, yeah.
Sweetie.
Let's not doing, give that
you know
idea.
What? You know what? There's only one way to solve this. Twitter.
Apparently, Twitter is the only way to get their.
I'm going to post
to get Project Ace's attention. That's how you do it. You go on Twitter. Yeah. Okay, and then it's perfect time to plug. Hey, you guys should follow me on Twitter, and then say that the Shin is the best
player.
Follow
me on Twitter at the Activase.
I'm gonna
be posting a poll there.
Let me put back the interview again, and then I'll put a poll right now. What's your favorite aircraft? Lift off into the sky,
which is wonderful. You put up the poll, and then we'll retweet it. Take a quick break, but we will be back with way more games. And then we gotta link ourselves. Follow us at.
Plug yourself.
Oh yeah, you have.
Let's do that. Let's do that right now.
So,
we're just doing the three aircraft,
and with the XFA 27 being one of the first fictional planes, which is history in and of itself.
And
I gotta go with that. So
the 27 and the Falcon were rivals to each other. So
they were, and that's a legendary battle.
But don't forget the true original aircraft. The XB-10.
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 Yes.
Go vote.
Hang on, it's almost ready.
Feeling when most of your followers are just sniped from Sly's followers.
I know.
We're all part of one big collective community here.
Yeah,
there's one
it
big
really is.
One sniping, roasting community.
The first vote, guys, the first vote I get is the ASF Shinden 2.
Don't you dare, Minwano. Don't you dare imply that anyone forgot about the Adler. I will be here to defend the Adler for the rest of my life.
What's Adler?
I will destroy you.
Who is she?
So think about the Falcon, okay? Then they just made it bigger. They just made it bigger.
Just made it bigger.
Soloing Pixie, have a good day, sir. Good night. Get some rest. We appreciate you coming out. the CFA-44 is winning. Yes.
It's so hard for me because I like all of them. They look good.
Pick one!
Confidential 1207. The Steam DLC page is going August 9th? What are you talking... Or September 8th. What are you talking about? I don't see anything. Nothing showed up. The DLC is not listed yet.
Yeah, they're still going... It's coming in fall. It's coming, guys, but it's not there yet.
Ah, don't forget the oldest original aircraft. That Lindworm gang.
Yes! Back from the 50s!
Was it canonically in the 50s?
Well, yeah, it was something like that. It was like the equivalent to the B-52.
Yeah, I would have liked to have seen the 40s too, but it hasn't been invented yet. Strange real.
Actually, let me look that up. Let's look our Lindworm boy. First flight in 1951.
Activase, do I even have to answer this one? Obviously, the best plan is the Nosferatu. Activase, we're going to make a proper Marian/Estevakian out of you yet. Ania. Ania. Ania.
God damn it, the Nosferatu is winning my poll too. I need to meddle this.
I am surprised how suddenly the Nosferatu became this big, Yeah, everyone was calling for it. I was very surprised by that.
It's a cult.
I didn't expect
Same here, because the real version of it was trapped on the Xbox 360 for ages.
It's almost like the hate for Ace Combat 6 isn't real.
Fuck that. Assault Horizon and Infinity had it. Come on.
Assault Fuck Horizon that. Had a bastardized version of it that...
Yes, sir. Yes, Seven Will 2. Seven Will 2.
Why, I will say.
Seven Will 2.
Seven I'm just hoping it's not as bad as Assault Horizons. Infinity's was better.
Oh, Thomas P., you're right. Ace Combat fan, we both mistranslated. Kona was what? Saying that it was initially impossible for the 44 to be developed. The 44, the aircraft, not the people.
Okay.
Oh, wait.
Thank you for that correction, Thomas P.
That actually makes sense.
But no, Ace, I think the biggest strike against A6 was its 360 exclusivity.
Absolutely.
That is what killed
it. It was killed before it had a chance.
Thanks, Microsoft.
I'll be damned if I let that be what brings down 6.
No, Shattered Sky, she said more than 30 on the DLC, not 30. So you're right.
Oh my god, I'm getting notifications like freaking crazy.
Me too.
It's exploding. Yeah. It's like Waifu Wars, but for planes. It's come on, guys. The Shinan's losing. We got only 18%. Where's my people?
Yes, because the Nosferatu is the best. What can I say?
I wish I could vote for all three.
ADMMs, rapid fire.
But if you vote for all three, it's like not voting.
I know, but it's like, it's just, I like them all. There's really not one plane that's really like, really got me on its side.
You well, know, your like, emblem has the XFA, so I'd assume you go for that.
Yeah.
Because of the history.
Please, four standard missiles, please.
Dude, I know. I would.
I think so. I think it might be in.
No, we don't know. There's nothing to say that.
Fingers crossed. One can hope.
People have been
positively.
Like, so actually, I meant to talk about this earlier because people have been like analyzing the DLC trailer, and. First of all, we saw that all of the Zero skins have no emblems. So
the emblems would have to probably be those, right?
No.
No, we have the emblems.
We have the emblems. They're multiplayer like bonuses. So
what new emblems?
No. I'm going to turn
on the PlayStation.
No.
Not what my point is that for the first time we might have skins that are not skins 1 through 3 that you can put emblems on.
Huh.
Which is going to be incredible for PC modders. Mm-hmm. Because people have been wondering, like, can we get skin slots where we can put whatever emblem we want? There you go, now we got a new one. The other thing is that... Fuck. I'll get back to you.
Okay.
The XFA 27. The XFA 27 has the same pylons that it had in Infinity, which implies the MSTM. But we don't know for sure.
And when it was loaded with the SOD, it only had.
I'm just glad the Cypher skin has its proper livery complete.
That's all that matters.
Marking. I want my Cypher.
My Cypher.
Best livery ever. My
hey, I'm happy to see it back. I really am.
Do you think the XFA 27 is going to post all? Maneuver.
If it has thrust vectoring, it should.
We talked about thrust vectoring.
I think the Acepedia server, the Nosferatu and the Shinden will likely have the full postal maneuver, but the XFA 27 will likely have the Morgans, where it can only
Cobra.
Probably, yeah.
This is ageism.
Someone mod.
Well, the XFA 27 doesn't have the full, like, thrust vectoring.
That was a question in the chat. I don't have a Discord link, but you guys probably should join the Ace Combat subreddit link.
There's a bunch,
but I don't have my own server.
There's Activace has one, I have one, Sly has one,
NetZone
has one. There's one for Acepedia.
I have one, but it's kind of small.
Josh has one.
Well,
Viper, LOL, when will the DLC appear?
No real names.
Sometime in the fall.
Yeah, we don't have the actual dates yet.
Yeah.
The MSTM, guys, was... No, it's some of you have the information incorrect. The ability to fire four standard missiles instead of two is exclusive to Ace Combat 2 and Ace Combat X if you equip a certain part. Infinity introduced the brand new special weapon, MSTM, which is just four more standard missiles, so you essentially have six standard missiles.
Yeah, and where you just go... Psh, psh,
psh, psh, psh. Joint Assault introduced the ODMM.
It's like, yes, Rockets Joint Assault and Legacy, it had the ODMM.
I mean, really, what the MSTM was just a way to get around having to code a new way to handle standard missiles.
But that's the thing, they actually did code more, because all of your parts that affected standard missiles also affected MSTMs in Infinity. None of your special weapon parts mattered.
That might just be a flag that they could enable.
But it had to be the very first time that a flag existed for the special weapon. Because no other special weapon had that ability.
Well, you know the reason why it had four special weapons in the four standard weapons at the beginning. There was no special weapon, so it was the only way for it to stand out, really.
I don't think that's what it was. Super. Because the only reason I say that that's not is because I think they wanted it super just to have, like, hey, you've unlocked this, you purchased this, here, four missiles. Not because special weapon. Otherwise, we would have somehow had a bomb.
Okay, I'm looking up the emblems right now on my PlayStation 4. We have Regards to Zero.
We have a wiki, you know.
I know, but I'm a little lazy and I just wanted to turn on my PlayStation 4.
So, do they think that it's going to be around $20? Oh, I think, weren't the planes around $5 each?
$5 each.
So, it should be something similar to five.
If it's going to be one pack, I can see it being $12. If it's going to be three packs, it's going to be $5 each.
Which would be in without tax, so...
And I will happily pay it.
Oh, I will pay it, too.
Well, tax and regional pricing, you know what I mean.
I will get all three of them. But most importantly, the Nosferatu.
We do have all of Zero's emblems, by the way. We have Crow, Rot, Indigo, Groon, Galt, Schnee, Silver, Wizard, Usio, Sappin, Six Air Division, Espada, Schwartz, Torso, Gal.
Yeah,
we have Crow.
I did not unlock that one. Wow.
Sortie in the F-16 and destroy 35 enemies in multiplayer.
But what emblems are we missing?
We're not getting J skin.
We don't have the emblems for Infinity, right? For the Butterfly Master, Ridgebacks,
no.
and all.
And that's no, I'm expecting the Butterfly Reaper. Master emblem. Reaper.
You don't
yes.
have Reaper on.
It would make sense.
Bring in Viper. Bring in the whole Bone Arrow Squadron. Please.
The Edge one.
Lancer, I don't think the skins are going to be fair. I think they're going to be bundled in with the aircraft.
Yeah, just like before.
So, they're going to be paid? That would be my guess.
Is there any, Estovakian emblem that is unique that we don't have currently?
Didn't they have the Vampire Squadron?
No.
But that never showed up?
They did not.
Like, we don't even know what it looks like.
Vampire Squadron never showed up.
Team.
Well, they showed up as the new Striggan team.
Yeah, exactly.
Right, they were assimilated.
Which is disappointing, because I would have loved to have seen Vampire's livery and emblem.
Only three Estovakian emblems exist. Striggan, 370th Airwing, and Estovakia. That's all we got.
Seven emblems.
And Emeria has, at least in seven, Garuda... The exclusive Garuda, which I'm hoping that they'll, you know, give to us, disc plebs.
No.
The Amerian Lovis, and Sly's favorite, Serval.
Oh, yeah. What do you mean exclusive Garuda?
The eight exclusive emblems that were for the deluxe digital.
Yeah, that's on console.
Without the.
Yeah, but I have it on disc.
Yeah.
Espada skin, no, but Espada emblem, yes.
We get the Espada skin for the Rafale.
Yeah. So my question is,
we don't have the Draken, so
will the deluxe emblem
dude,
be...
come on. Don't
no, no, they won't be. I'm sure they won't, brothers.
I know.
Well,
I
damn.
Because you can buy the deluxe edition on disc. It just comes with a code for the stuff. I feel like I just blew your mind somehow.
Oh, I did not unlock that skin. I am a failure.
It was digital only back.
Oh,
at least in Kansas City.
No. I think you're right. Never mind.
You know, you know, it'd be a fun theory that, you know, it's just a theory, so it probably won't be true.
A game what theory.
What if the new emblems, and some of those new emblems are completely brand new, something we've never seen before.
Bullshit.
And they're hinting at the next Ace Combat game.
Like, no, they would not do that. Not to the next Ace Combat. It could be an emblem that, like, we heard about this squadron, but we never seen the emblem of this squadron. I could see that. But for the next Ace Combat, no.
I can see the Empire team.
What did I just
You know what they're gonna add? They're gonna add Infinite 111 from Infinity, and people are gonna freak out thinking that that's what
Oh god.
No, but people are gonna freak out
thinking there's the next Infinity.
Reaper's emblem.
The Ace
exactly.
Infinity.
Or the red Mobius ribbon.
Plot twist, red Mobius was actual Mobius from Ace Combat 4, and
red
that's
Mobius
what the IUN
used. It's just Zoe.
For those of you who are joining us, because I'm seeing a lot of people, the CFA-44, XFA-27, and Shinden 2 from Assault Horizon, all three of them are the new DLC aircraft coming this autumn. No, they do not come as part of your season pass. You must purchase them separately. They come with 7 skins each, as well as all of the Zero skins are coming as well, and 20 new emblems.
Which we don't know yet, the emblems.
Which we don't know the skins that they're... the aircraft are coming with either. So
we also don't know if they're all going to be in one pack or if they're going to be split into three.
No.
So
a lot of this we don't know. So
I'm guessing one pack because we're getting like the skins and the emblems too. So
have there been other hints at an upcoming Ace title? Try again next year.
Yeah.
please.
We have Project Wingman.
Also
yeah,
next
Project
year.
Wingman.
Also next year.
Also next year.
And that's... Project Wingman, that's
also next year.
That is the next Ace Combat. Worst fan. It's the next Ace Combat.
Well, think of it this way, guys. For those of you that are like, oh, why isn't it in my season pass? What was the season pass? $25. What was the value of the 6 DLCs? $30. You want them to reduce the value of the season pass even further? Come on. Stop being so stingy. Pay up.
Well, but then, then how long is that season pass gonna go for? Like,
well,
the season
is season pass. The season has ended.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Otherwise, the season would be the life of the game.
We're in year two.
We are in the worst.
I didn't
year.
Know seasons last for 2 years, guys.
I don't know, man. Maybe if this was Westeros, but. We don't want to talk about that.
Okay, I think the votes have kind of stabilized now. Shinden 18%, XFA 27%, and Ashrata 54%.
Wait, the XFA 27% is 27%.
Yes. It's not a joke. It's not a joke.
That's
it's
done.
Not a
it's
joke.
Done. Close the poll.
Close it.
Chat.
No, there's still 23 hours left.
This man.
23 hours.
There still is a chance. Come on, guys. We'll change in the place.
You know
Frost,
what? From now
Frost
on,
McGregor,
from now on, we gotta tell people that are saying, like, oh, have they seen this game? Assault Horizon 2 was announced. Like, that's what you should just say from now on.
Enjoy!
Yeah.
More DFM. DFM required.
Yes.
For every dogfight.
That is a
serious question. You guys covered a lot in the past. What about the Tempest? What about it? I don't see it. Do you see it? I don't see it.
Look, here's what happened with the Tempest.
See you
okay?
next year.
Here's what happened with the Tempest. The people making the Tempest in the UK invited the people from Paraiso to come visit. That's it. But
yeah, but that was how long ago?
Oh, that's pretty cool though. Oh, that was last year, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. It was.
But still, that's pretty cool.
We Kono awesome. Did also hear about was it Taiwan's indigenous fighter?
No.
And he was like, wow, it'd be interesting if we could add that to 7. That was like 3.
Oh, okay, yeah.
If they could do it without, you know, China.
But they down on it. But they did get the promotional material for the Chinese planes, too. Like, you know, they got the, like, some magazines or some posters or whatever.
Yeah, whatever that was about.
But that's how you promote new fighter jets. You put them in video games, and then you convince countries to buy them based on video games. That's the new way.
Is multiplayer dead still?
Yeah.
Probably. Yeah, kind of, yeah.
I refuse.
I just joined. I see there's no DLC on PS4 yet. Luztic, it releases later this year.
In fall.
So at the very earliest, toward the end of September.
At the very latest, December.
If we can wait 12 years, we can wait a couple months.
Hey, if it releases on December 12th, which is technically still in the fall, that'd be on my birthday.
Woo!
Yay.
I get the feeling the Nosferatu is going to be the first one, not the last one.
Yeah, we actually saw all
popularity.
We saw the animation in the trailer of the weapon pots popping out.
I don't mean like that. I mean, like, I think people are going to be expecting the Nosferatu first.
Yeah, yeah.
It was also the first in the trailer, so.
Yeah, but but in the interview, it wasn't. I think he switched it up.
Fair enough.
I'm just laughing like so hard just reading this. Like, oh, they're not gonna do this. They're not gonna do that. So I'm not gonna pay for this. Like, oh, okay. Don't support them. Don't give them the money. See what happens. Like, what do you expect?
Get wrecked by the Nosferatu chumps.
Yeah.
Well,
I'm kidding.
Support the devs. Support the game that you like. If you don't like the game, then what are you doing watching this?
Yeah. Yeah, if you don't like it, you don't have to buy it.
Suggestions like the Fenrir or the Varkalok, I'm not surprised that they didn't bring those in because, one, it wasn't in the 25th anniversary wallpaper.
They're not as popular either. I'm just saying the fact. I'm not saying there aren't people that like them, but there are more people who like the Nosferatu.
More Fenrir, people have called for those, so.
Fenrir also technically hasn't been invented yet in Strange Real.
That, whatever.
Yeah, nobody cares about that.
So
we can play with time.
Neither has the Shinden. 1995.
Also,
well, technically, I guess you could say that Infinity is Strange Real on real Earth, so.
Shinden also, is not in Strange Real.
Yeah, but it's,
it
a,
is now.
It's a developer's favorite. It is now. As well.
Also, on the Varkalak, we can't have the Varkalak because this is PG-12.
What?
Look, though, like, if they couldn't fit the Nosferatu in the hangar, I don't think it's gonna fit the Varkalak, because even Crash and Joint Assault, like, when you had the formation flight. So.
Varkalak is just like. How long is the Varkalak?
Wait, Higo Trees, I'm seeing, guys, there's not going to be another, like, $25 season pass. There's no missions. It's just three aircraft. I don't know what you guys are going on about.
Guys, the season pass was for last year. The season pass were the 6 DLCs. DLC 1, DLC 2, DLC 3 is called
the
ADF pack.
Series.
Is what I'm calling it.
And that's all done.
And then 4, 5, and 6 was your...
Taurus
Alicorn, Sink Alicorn DLC story pack.
I call
that was
Taurus
season
saga.
One. That was last year. Okay, so season pass, you were like, oh, hey, more DLCs coming out for 2019. You know what? I'll just buy the season pass so then it comes out and I can just download it. I don't have to worry about buying each one separately. And then you got all 6. That's how it works. Now, Project Aces did not know if they were going to make more content for the future for Ace Combat 7. So far, according to sales and then what they're seeing and fan support, they decided, yes, let's add more to the game. We are listening to people's responses on Twitter, on social media. We're going to give the people what they wanted. What do they want? They want more fictional planes. And those fictional planes were the Nosferatu, the XFA-27, and the Shinden 2.
And as I said, they've been researching that on Twitter. So it's not like they just picked out a random...
What new season pass could they give us, Delta Wolf? Please tell me. 3 aircraft? What else could they put in the season pass?
I mean,
please. What did we miss? What did we not see?
I mean, if they're gonna do a season two pass, might as well just bulk them all together in one giant pack. Because that's about what you'd be paying for.
Still to Wolf. At this point, 2020 and moving onward with Ace Combat 7, we don't. Project Aces and us, we don't know if more DLC or content is going to be added to Ace Combat 7 until Ace Combat 8. We don't even know when Ace Combat 8 is going to be coming out. We don't
know what the game plan is.
We don't know that Ace Combat 8 is a thing.
Okay, that we don't know, but I have a feeling it's going to happen eventually, one day.
I'm saying what I mean is that people call it Ace Combat 8. I'm just saying the next Ace Combat game. No one knows what that's going to be, what it's going to be called, or what it's going to be.
That's true. That's true. In that sense, yes. Yes.
Right.
Three missions about Excalibur.
Hire me to write that shit. I've got everything ready.
Heck, the next Ace Combat game could be a remake of Ace Combat 4. Just, we don't know.
What? Don't do that to my heart.
I had that before.
I'm just saying, we don't know.
Don't give him hope.
Don't give me hope.
Don't give me hope.
I mean,
don't do that.
So what you mean is we're going back to the good old days of Strange Real just being used here.
Ethan Jones, what about the Sorcerer skin? What about it? Do you see an SMTD? I don't see an SMTD. Do you?
I'd rather a remake of
Zero. We're going to have to get the mods.
Get all the PS2 games. Come on, the Holy Trilogy.
Remakes. Not remasters, remakes, please. But
they know. Like, Project Aces, they know. They've said, they've talked about it. And even if they were going to announce anything like that, like,
they'd also have to modify the aircraft selection, because I don't see how they're going to get the Tornado back.
No, my point is, like, if they were going to announce anything like that, that would have been at the anniversary. But then COVID. So, patience, people, patience.
Look, you waited 12 years for Ace Combat 7. I think you can wait a couple more months.
A couple more months for these aircraft, and then wait until next year for whatever else comes next.
I believe in you guys. I believe in you.
And in the meantime, play Project Rayman.
Yes.
There's a demo coming.
But that's also next year.
Test VR.
Well, Sly, what do you want me to say? This year's horrible, okay?
I know, I'm just saying, look forward to the DLC aircraft that we can finally fly, the XFA-27, in a
console game again. This year!
And if you're a console peasant, well, and the CFA-24. I guess we're fucked.
In console peasants, you get the Cypher skin and you get these aircraft as well.
Well, no, ACF was going on about Project Wingman.
Oh, like, no.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I didn't mean to make you feel bad.
And if you're on a console, you're fucked.
Yeah, you're fucked.
I did not mean to make you feel that way, okay.
I'm the token American console peasant.
What else can we take away from this?
Calamitous, you're talking about Kono posting another tweet. I saw that. It's just thanking everyone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
I guess.
Please follow the hashtag Kono Cares.
Hashtag Kono Cares.
Yeah. I guess that's going to be it for this stream, unless you guys have something else to talk about. That was a good weekend.
Actually, I do have something to say. You know, I know we were talking about earlier how, like, how much, you know, Sly doesn't really give a shit about the Nosferatu, but I just have to say that it is by far one of the most amazing aircraft I've ever seen in my life. I don't care what
we're gonna need a Dirty Bat versus Pinhead Wyvern War once they come out. We're going to need to see which one's better. So Wyvern Squad versus Nosferatu Squad. We're going to need to watch it.
Bring it on. Here's the thing. We can do that when this comes out.
Sly, if we get rapid fire EMLs, you're in trouble. Because I'd like to be able to use it.
If the goddamn Nosferatu is not nerfed at all, I concede. I admit defeat.
If the Nosferatu has the same flight characteristics as it does in 6, I will update my how to fly the Nosferatu video that I have for 6, because if it has the same flight characteristics, you need to keep your speed up.
All right, I won't launch it because it flies.
Yes.
What if it flies like an assault horizon?
Oh yeah.
You basically not keep it straight.
If it's anything like the Assault Horizon one, then I will be crying. I'll still buy it, but I will be crying.
It was so much fun. That cat thing was barely controllable. I loved it.
Oh, we just provoked
the game
more.
Well, that was it. That's all I had to add.
Okay, some people are coming with some theories that Project Wingman is sponsoring me, okay? That's not true. I sponsor Project Wingman!
Yeah. Way, I'm pretty sure the fans sponsor them. It's not really.
Yeah.
They don't have the money to sponsor anybody like that.
Fan was supremely surprised to see us yesterday, so.
Yeah, we had Fan here. It was a good talk.
It was very awesome. Very good.
I'm excited.
It's like talking to like a future Kono, kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
let's not go that far yet.
Yeah, I.
No, I don't feel bad. Kono looks so tired.
I guess.
Oh no,
I guess
Fan
if
has
you want
got
to call
be
him
like
Kono.
He's exhausted.
Yeah. Take care, Kono. Please, please understand. Take care.
What time is it for him?
It's past midnight for Kono.
For sure.
It's 1 a.m.
It's 1 a.m.
Okay, they're a little. Okay, so
I wonder he looks
large.
Tired.
No, but that
was pre-recorded.
Oh, good.
Yeah, that's like.
He's
I
tweeting
mean,
live, but.
Kono, go to sleep. You need it.
He needs to celebrate.
New airplane skins, yeah, Metal Gear and emblems, which is all we said was going to be. That anyone that was expecting different hyped themselves up. Any new missions? No.
What do you guys? Metal Gear is the same.
I was wondering for a second if you were talking about Metal Gear skins.
I mean,
oh,
yeah. No.
Like,
I...
We got Metal Gear skins. We got Idolmaster skins. We got Idolmaster emblems. They're all straight from Infinity.
I have
if they bring out the Idolmaster skins, I'm going to have to do an Idolmaster playthrough for that.
Like, I mean, what else are they going to add, though? It's true. Like, the game is complete. They can add more planes, skins, emblems, all they want.
I mean, they can't really go much past... I mean, I guess they could go past the game's ending, but then you're going into the Aurelian War.
No, I mean... But then it'll be a different war. I'm not sure if they want to go that deep. Because what they did with the DLC's missions is that it's missions in between the story missions.
So it's in between Bunker Buster and
Training. Yeah. So it kind of made some sense, kind of.
If they were going to do DLC missions at this point, there's no room for them. If we're flying as Trigger, there's no room for them to give more story missions. It would have to be... like Ace of Aces or Challenge Missions or something. And those take a lot of development to do, which they don't have the resources for right now.
Speaking of Ace of Aces, that is the one regret I have with A6. I never got those DLC, and I'm kicking myself.
I'll help you go through
them. I never owned an Xbox, so I can't. I feel your pain, brother.
Yeah, fuck Xbox, though. Hey, Series X, what launch games?
Sly.
I think I heard this. Oh, let's not start the console wars. We're already having a plane war.
I have both PlayStation and Xbox, so I have no dog in the fence.
Game. I think I've heard this one before.
Oh, I am starting the console war.
Wait, let's check the status on the plane war.
The 360 won its generation, the PS4 won its generation, and the PS5 will win its generation. It.
Slam dunk.
So...
Okay, right now, Shinden 18%.
All, so I'm not going to render an opinion.
I think Microsoft is trying to get out of the gaming console business, and...
Oh, they're like long, deep inside the hole of PC gaming. Like,
they don't give a shit anymore on consoles, so...
They're good. I mean, even then, though, they're doing fine in the PC business, so...
Hey, Minwana, we're all friends here, though.
Yeah.
We give each other shit because we care.
Yeah, he said you guys are like Belkans, war with everything.
We understand.
Goddamn Belkans, they ruined Belka.
Look at my emblem, I am a Marian.
It's like that Simpson jokes, like Belkans are, how is it, how do you say it? Our natural enemies, just like brothers and sisters. Like, there's Belkans and Oceans, there's Belkans and Yuktobanians, Belkans and Ustios, then there's the North Belkans and the South Belkans. Sorry, the execution wasn't
damn
that good.
Belkans.
But that's deep!
That's deep.
Not in that sense, okay? It's a family-friendly stream.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, always is. Today we had the admittance from ACF that South Belkans is a thing.
No, South Belkans are like the inferior Belkans. I'm glad they're gone.
Oh.
Like, who surrenders? Like, who does that?
No, that's okay. We can have them. We'll keep the factory too.
Meanwhile,
no, that's okay. That's our property, though.
After their war, because it is canon that Emeria purchases two Nosferatus from Estevakia after the war.
But did they really purchase?
So they actually purchased them, and not like Aureli, who just fucking took them, took the Fenrir.
No, but how much did they pay? How much did they pay? They could have paid $1.
Well, seeing as how Emeria's bank probably bankrolling Estevakia's economy after the war.
Again. Or the what time? How many times?
At least the third.
It is the third, though. It really is.
What?
This is after six ends, Emeria starts bailing out Estevakia for the third goddamn time.
Goddamn!
Really want the Republic of Ania? We want that to be a thing.
Nosferatu is saying no, man.
Just
can't.
Give us
our neutrality will be affected.
Like
Nicholas sent a super chat for £5.
What do you think about the other skin we saw in the wallpaper? Will they give us to like the US skin pack? Maybe. I don't know. We only have the zero skins.
They haven't said anything. We have
I don't know how it's going to be split.
SU-33 Striggan, but
if we never get
it, I'm not going to be terribly disappointed because what we're getting is more than I thought we'd ever get.
There's a few good candidates for us to get beyond that too, like the UPO Typhoon.
And as much as I love Ace Combat 6, if we never get Talisman's F-15E livery, I'm not going to be disappointed because it is boring as fuck.
What livery?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just a wonderful, vibrant color of gray.
Whenever I play A6 and I'm using the F-15E, I don't use the Amerian skin. I use Cyphers.
Oh, well.
I see questions about backwards compatibility for the next. Yeah, 7 should be playable. The PS4 copy of 7 should be playable on PS5, and the Xbox One copy of 7 and 6 should be playable on Series X.
That'd be the only reason I'm eventually getting the Series X.
Wait, but if you...
They're DLC, they're paid,
just
not free.
In case my
but if
Xbox
you downloaded the... If you download Ace Combat 5, then you should be also be able to play Ace Combat 5 on the PS5, right?
Yep.
That's not... I'm not so sure about that one, because... Very few people own 5.
Yeah, so, but it's on their store, right? If you have it.
It's on the store as a PS4 game. It's ported specifically for the PS4. Don't know if that... Because that PS2 emulator that they use is PS4 specific. We don't know if that's on PS5 yet.
Okay, yeah.
I will let you know because I'm probably going to get a PS4.
The one advantage that Microsoft has over the PlayStation is it's always been backwards compatibility.
No, wait. GT Mike, no, the zero skins are not free.
Yes, they're not.
They come in the packs, but we don't know how the packs are going to come yet. We don't know if it's together or if it's split or whatever.
I mean, if you want to consider the you're buying the aircraft and the skins come bonus with it, I guess you could call it free, but you still have to pay for them.
Honestly, anyway, I'm surprised that people have such problems with the pricing model. 7 is far more forgiving with its DLC prices. All the previous games. All of them.
Oh, yeah.
We're not just comparing to other Ace Combat games.
I mean, I am the biggest Ace Combat 6 shill you'll ever meet, but...
Yeah,
I
that works.
I didn't buy the DLC skins separately. I had to buy them in the packs because if you bought them all separately, it racked up the price pretty bad.
Even the packs were racking up. Like, jeez.
I think Assault Horizon was worse on that end because at least the Ace Combat 6 skins, they were basically a new aircraft in terms of performance.
Except for the SU-47 ones. See my DLC showcase for that.
Yeah, but at least they introduced... that was the general rule towards Ace Combat 6. Like, every aircraft performed in a vastly different manner. And they kept that going with the skins. So, there was at least the gameplay value there that wasn't even there for Assault Horizon. And
yeah,
I think we're actually more expensive.
The Idolmaster skins, they definitely threw a wrench in your gameplay, because the S16 ones, both the F2 and the F16, they would lock you into roll loops or pitch loops, which, if you're not expecting it, is pretty pretty hard to deal with. The Typhoon.
Wait for it. Now I'm locked.
Yeah. That's about how long it takes to lock on. And in my playthrough, my Idolmaster playthrough for Invasion Grace or Liberation Grace Maria, RNG gave me the Typhoon. The mission with the most targets, and I have the hardest time locking on. Luckily, the Typhoon comes with the Our Lord and Savior RCL, which doesn't give a shit about locking on.
Oh, yeah.
So, thank God for that, but oh yes, God.
You got a few air-to-air kills with that.
Uh-huh.
A few air-to-air rocket kills, which...
Oh, yeah.
Not entirely difficult, but was always ever so satisfying.
Oh, using the A-10 against the aerial fleet is hilarious.
Oh, fun times, yeah.
Oh, God.
And I remember from Infinity where everyone was grabbing all the meta bomb could and Lagm SMTD, and I was just flying against Moby Dick with my RCL grip, and then they nerfed the air-to-ground weapons. But not the rockets, because they weren't.
It's technically not air-to-ground, it's just special. It's an unguided launcher. It's like the lasers and the railguns. And the MGP, they are direct fire weapons. Its own category, so yeah, they nerfed the bombs or the air-to-ground missiles. Rocket launcher, don't give a shit.
Good times.
Okay, I think I'm gonna end the stream because I gotta get going.
Alrighty.
Alrighty.
Some Project Wingman projects.
Yes. I'm just kidding. I am, actually. But thanks for everybody that came. We got like over 1,000 people. I have no idea what the limit or what the number was.
It went above like 1,017, I think, was our peak.
Yeah.
I didn't pay attention.
Wait. I'm measuring now on YouTube.
Oh, no.
1,095.
Nice. Oh, no. What?
Neat.
Kono.
What?
Oh.
Oh, God. What just
happened? He tweeted in English.
Oh, no.
He saw the IGN chat. My interview had a lot of bad reputation in chat, but if the overseas Ace Combat fans were happy, I'd be good. Thanks to everyone who cares.
I'm tweeting him now.
Boring. Oh, that's kind of like the Kono kid.
Okay. Oh, God. IGN, you...
Worried about. yeah, dude, that's just...
we just need to make it because the people... that watch IGN.
How can that fan?
They don't
send him the link to this stream.
They don't. Yeah.
He needs to know that all of us were literally here.
How can I say that without sounding bad? Like, I don't want to say the Ace Cup.
Don't say that IGN was shit. Like, say that we were watching and we appreciated every second. Okay. Something like that.
I don't want to shit too much on IGN, but the truth is, IGN has the audience that's like all random people, right? Not just Ace Combat people. Probably a few Ace Combat people. I mean, if you're watching for Ace Combat, you're probably here or watching with Zapdropsticks and somebody else, right? I guess. I don't know. But you wouldn't be.
We were watching Project Wingman the other day. How many people do you think in chat were like, "What is this? Like, give me whatever the next."
Oh, a bunch of people.
Like, people are going to just be dicks. That's all it is.
Yeah. That's okay. I'll end the stream now and I'll reply to Kono. So please give your love to Kono on Twitter.
I'm letting him know.
Hashtag Kono cares.
Hashtag Kono cares. Very important hashtag of our days. He looks so tired. I feel bad for him, but he's working hard.
He looked so exhausted.
Okay, thank you guys for coming. Thank you, you two guys, for hosting together with me. We had a fun time.
Thank you for having us.
Yes, thank you.
It has been an amazing weekend.
We'll do more streams. I promise. I'm trying to get back into the YouTubes.
Listen, I told you, and everyone in chat can verify, your internet is much better now.
Finally!
You finally upgraded.
I am cool with like doing more of this in the future.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that. Thanks guys for coming, and I'll see you guys next time.
Bye everyone. Right.
Bye everybody.
Yep.
Bye. Love you guys.
Bye.